Good morning, everybody. Happy Friday. Today I chose to read Diary of a Worm by Doreen Cronin because I had a great idea. While you guys are at home, you could start a diary. And it's just like a journal, and you write about what you do each day. But it would be such a great way to remember what you've done, so when you see all your friends again, you can tell them all the great things that you got to do at home. Sounds good? Do you have a diary? Like that book? I think so. So let's see what this little guy does in his diary. March 20th. Mom says there are three things I should always remember. 1. The earth gives us everything we need. 2. When we dig tunnels, we help take care of the earth. It says, must make tunnel, must help earth breathe. And 3, never bother daddy when he's eating the newspaper. Worms are so silly. I like his little hat. Oh, thank you, thank you. March 29th. Today, I tried to teach Spider how to dig. Look at Spider. What does he have in his little bubble? Question mark. He's like, huh? First of all, his legs got stuck. I think I twisted one of my ankles. Then he swallowed a bunch of dirt. I give up. Tomorrow he's going to teach me how to walk upside down. Do you think that'll go well? Do you think a worm could walk upside down like a spider? I don't know. March 30th. Worms cannot walk upside down. Thank goodness Spider had his web, huh? Saved him. April 4th. Fishing season started today. We all dug deeper. Did you guys hear something? Uh-oh. April 10th. It rained all night and the ground got soaked. We spent the entire day on the sidewalk. Hopscotch is a very dangerous game. A scary couple days for worms. April 15th, I forgot my lunch today. I got so hungry that I ate my homework. My teacher made me write, I will not eat my homework 10 times. When I was finished, I ate that too. April 20th, where are you going? I snuck up on some kids in the park today. They didn't hear me coming. I wiggled right up between them and they screamed. I love when they do that. He went right into their marble game. May 1st. Grandpa taught us that good manners are very important. So today I said good morning to the first aunt I saw. There were 600 more of them in line. Good morning, good morning, good morning. How you doing? Good morning. Nice to see you. Howdy. Good morning. I stood there all day. That was very kind of him. May 8th. Had the worst nightmare last night. Giant birds playing hopscotch. Mom says I have to stop eating so much garbage right before I go to bed. Whew, that would be a nightmare for a worm. May 15th. I got into a fight with Spider today. He told me you need legs to be cool. Then he ran. I couldn't keep up. Maybe he's right. No. May 16th. I made Spider laugh so hard he fell out of his tree. Who needs legs?
Thud.
They're good friends. Even if you get in a little argument with your friends, if they're good friends, they'll stick around. May 28th. Last night I went to the school dance. You put your head in, you put your head out. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself about. And that's all we could do. Because they're worms. They don't have arms or legs. June 5th. Today we made macaroni necklaces in art class. Oh, there's 4 steps. Step 1, put your head in the macaroni. Step 2, wiggle. Step 3, squirm. Step 4, stretch. I brought mine home and we ate it for dinner. You're very talented. June 15th. My older sister thinks she's so pretty. I told her that no matter how much time she spends looking in the mirror, her face will always look just like her rear end. That's true. How can you tell the front and the back of a worm? I can't. Spider thought that was really funny. Mom did not.
Uh-oh, he's getting in trouble now.
July 4th. When I grow up, I want to be a Secret Service agent. Spider says I will have to be very careful because the president might step on me by mistake.
It's a dangerous job, I told him. But someone's got to do it.
I like his little suit. July 28th. Three things I don't like about being a worm. 1. I can't chew gum. 2. I can't have a dog. 3. All that homework. He's got homework on digging and soil and compost. It's all very important things for worms. July 29th. Three good things about being a worm. 1. I never have to go to the dentist. No cavities. No teeth either. 2. I never get in trouble for tracking mud through the house. And 3. I never have to take a bath. He said, who's my grubby little boy? That's pretty good about being a worm. Do you think that would be a good idea for us? Pew, pew. August 1st. It's not always easy being a worm. We're very small, and sometimes people forget that we're even here. But, like Mom always says, the Earth never forgets we're here. Because worms are great for the Earth and for the soil. The end. He's got some pictures in his diary. If you make a diary, you can put some pictures in there too. And you can draw pictures. You don't always have to take a picture. Ooh, a bee stung me. Isn't this leaf awesome?
It's money. He ate the money.
I found this really cool rock. That's a baseball. Mom and Dad's anniversary. Gross. They're doing a smooch. My own comic. My sister's slumber party. My favorite pile of dirt. And that is it. The end. So, I want you guys to try it out. I would like for you to try and make your very own diary. And guess what? You don't need a special kind of diary. You can use anything. You can use pieces of paper, staple them together, or fold the corners to keep them together. You can use an old notebook, anything to make a diary. Or you just fold some papers in half like that, and they'll stay together like that. So write down what you've been doing, and it's a good way to keep track of what you do during your days. I will try and attach a journal to this video, and that way if you can print, or if you'd like to print, you can have your very own journal, just like the ones we used to have in class. All right, have a great day. Say goodbye. Bye. Go play. Bye, guys.